Welcome, everybody. Thanks for coming all the way here. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of the Hindu Temple and the Executive Committee, I'd like to welcome you all to this spectacular dance drama performed by over close to about 40 participants, including small children, teenagers, and even elders. They are going to enact the journey of Prince Rama, depicting in a dance form the victory of good over evil. Before we begin, I want to say something about why we are here. Back in May of 2016, when we do our yearly Brahmotsavam, Smitha had performed a dance event. She performs that regularly every year in our temple. And a few of us from the EC committee were, after the event, we were sitting and just thinking about how to raise money for the new temple. Well, let me pause. Since I said the new temples, I'm going to take a digression and have Sundar Munagala, the BOT EC chair, speak a few words about our new temple, and then I'll come back.
Thank you, everyone, and again, welcome. Thank you for coming. And do you know when the first vision for our temple was conceived? In 1999, a group of elders felt that our community needed a temple to help our community so much. So in 1999, they met in a Ramadan hotel just over a cup of coffee, and they discussed this. And in 2004, they purchased our current facility at 1700 Naimar Drive. In 2008, our temple, we had our first priest and performed Murti Pratishtha and Kumbhabhishekam. It was a very big event at that time. And since then, we have come a long way. The demographics of people visiting to our temple has increased, and the need for more space to our temple has increased. And then we have around 800 to 1,000 families in Cedar Rapids, Iowa City, and Waterloo. And there are at least more than 1,000 people that are registered in our mailing database. We thought of new temple for example, just for the Diwali. There were 350 people who attended the Diwali event, and there was no space at all. Actually, they were really crowded. Even to walk, it was difficult. So we sat around and thought the pros and cons of having a new temple. I know there's a lot of financial issues that come with it. And then we thought we should purchase a new temple. Then we bought a beautiful land in Robbins. It's a very nice location and a very safe location, very close to Highway 380, just 1.5 to 2 miles from Highway 380. And the group who took over the land really worked very hard for it, and finally we got the land. And now we are at a place where we are we have found our construction group, RateNet, our construction group, and we had several sittings with them. And we finalized them as our builders, and we have three phases of construction. Phase one, it is a preliminary engineering for budget estimation. It will be completed by 15th of December 2016. And phase two, detailed building design, city code, and approval. Final budget by March 2017. And phase three, construction engineering and project management, will start in May 2017. Financially, it will take about 1.2 million overall for the project cost. And so we need to raise that money. We need to raise at least 500K through our fundraising efforts. Friends, we need all your help. In any way, it matters. Friends, together we make a big difference. Never think You are a drop in the ocean. Every drop makes the ocean stronger. And we want people to come forward to help us in the fundraising. And actually, fundraising is an art of teaching the joy of giving. And fundraising, you should take it as a pride, not an apology, when asking for a good cause. And it is the catalyst for change. And friends, giving is the best therapy. Thank you.
And I'd just like to mention that there are some brochures outside that shows you the idea and the project plan for the new temple. There are some donation forms also, so whenever, you know, during the break or after the event, please take a look and collect some of those brochures. Now, let's come back to why we are here. As I was saying during our proposal event, few of the EC committee members were talking about how to figure out the fundraising, you know, many ideas. So Smitha came up to us and said, how about we perform, or we have an event where some of the local talent can perform. Serves two purposes. One is allows the local talent to demonstrate what they have in them and gives this platform as a exposure to all of you about the new temple and raise some funds. So we asked her if she would be able to do it. And did she respond with so much enthusiasm that we just couldn't let this opportunity go? She said, yes, we will do it. Fast forward to today. 5 months of hours and hours of practice and hard work every weekend, pretty much Saturday and Sunday. This group are here now to perform in front of you, and we will see the fruits of their hard labor. So without further ado, I would like to get this with us group here on stage. But before we start, I just have a few rules that I'd like to go through. Please try to remain in attendance during the entire program. I assure you, you will enjoy it. Make sure all your cell phones, beepers, and alarms are off in silent mode. We don't want the children to be distracted. There are no drinks or foods allowed in the auditorium, so please keep it out. And lastly, I'm sure we have a lot of small children here who will enjoy the performance, but in case they need attention, please make sure to follow appropriate etiquette. So with that, I'd like to present Smitha's Sampradaya troupe, The Epic Journey of Rama.
Thank you. परमेश्वर तू मोरया चिंता मनी तू सिद्धि नाए को गणाधीशाय मोरया वक्रतुंड तू गज मुखा तू सिद्धि विनायक वक्रतुंड तू गज मुखा तू सिद्धि विनायक गजानन 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 गणराय गजानन गजानन
Namaskar. Welcome to Ramayana, the journey of Prince Ram, a dance ballet presented by the Sampradaya dance troupe, directed by Smitha Khullar. Shri Ram, Lord Vishnu's seventh incarnation. Our story begins in the land of Ayodhya, thousands of years ago, in the kingdom of Kosal, King Dashrath is an ideal king, virtuous, brave, and kind. With his three wives, Dashrath lives a prosperous life, but with one grief, he has no heir. Following the advice of Guru Vashishth, King Dashrath performs a ritual with his wives and is blessed with four sons. Queen Kaushalya's Ram, Queen Kaikeyi's Bharat, and Queen Sumitra's twins, Lakshman and Shatrughna. The kingdom rejoices the birth of the princes.
Takatajam, 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 takat
Princes Ram, Bharat, Lakshman and Shatrughna are sent to Guru Vashishth's Gurukul, a residential school, where they live and study till their youth. The four young princes become proficient in various subjects, arts and warring techniques. At the end of their training, Guru Vishwamitra visits and asks King Dashrath for Ram and Lakshman to go with him to the forest where he is performing a yajna, a ritual. The demons Marich and Tatak are disturbing the yajna, and Ram and Lakshman are needed to protect the sages. King Dashrath agrees, and Ram and Lakshman leave with sage Vishwamitra. Thank you.
dapagasati trigama dapa dapagasati trigama dapa padani
In the forest, Ram and Lakshman fight Marich, Tatak, and all the other demons and protect the sages. Guru Vishwamitra is very happy at the successful completion of his yajna and suggests that Ram and Lakshman go with him to the kingdom of Mithila, where King Janak is performing the Swayamvar, or groom selection, for Princess Sita.
Neelagrivam shashankangam nagayajnopavedinam Vyadhadarmottariyanjavarenyamabhayapradam Kamandalvakshasotlanadharinam shulavaninam Jvalandam bengalajatashikhamadhyotatharinam Vrishastandha samarodham upadehattadharinam Amrutena Rudam Shantam Divya Bhoga Samanvitam Dikdevata Samayuktam Sura Sura Namastam Ityam Tasa Sakam Sattam Sura 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 hrudayam mayi aham amrute amratam brahmani prithivi me sharire svita.
Arriving in Mithila, Ram and Sita meet for the first time. Sita wonders if the handsome prince will come for her Swayamvar the next day.
Tare tani, tere na tere tani.
Mithila, King Janak has arranged a Swayamvar, a groom contest for his daughter Sita. The prince who can lift and string the mighty Shiva's bow will marry his daughter Sita. Many princes from all around the land come to try their strength and luck. None of them are even able to lift the bow, except King Ravan of Lanka. But even he cannot string the bow. Finally, Ram not only lifts the bow, but also strings it with so much strength that the mighty bow breaks. King Janak and everyone present is amazed at this display. Ram and Sita get married.
வேளை வந்தது ಮಡಿಯ ವೇದಿಟ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣ ರಾಮ ಕೆಳಂದ
Dashrath's second wife, Kaikeyi, is busily preparing for Ram and Sita's return and Ram's coronation as king. Her maid, Manthara, poisons Kaikeyi's mind, saying that once Ram becomes king, he will treat Kaikeyi's son Bharat badly and he will become sidelined. Manthara reminds Kaikeyi of the two wishes that King Dashrath had granted her in the past. She convinces Kaikeyi to ask for those wishes now. Kaikeyi demands the two wishes from King Dashrath. First, Ram is to be exiled to the forest for 14 years. And second, her son Bharat must be made the king. Ram complies with his mother's wishes and leaves for the forest for 14 years with his wife Sita and brother Lakshman. King Dashrath is heartbroken and dies soon thereafter. When Bharat hears what his mother has done, he reprimands her and refuses to take his brother Ram's place as king. He decides to visit Ram in the forest and persuade him to come back.
Thank you.
Ram and Bharat meet, but Ram refuses to go back as he has promised his mother Kaikeyi that he would comply with her wishes. Unable to convince Ram to come back to Ayodhya, Bharat decides to rule the kingdom on Ram's behalf. He takes Ram's padukas, or sandals, as a symbol and returns to Ayodhya. Forest, Ram, Sita and Lakshman settle into a simple life. One day, the demoness Shurpanakha sees Ram, falls in love with him and asks him to marry her. Ram refuses and sends her to Lakshman. Lakshman mocks her and teases her. Shurpanakha feels insulted by Ram and Lakshman, becomes angry and tries to kill Sita so that Ram can be hers. However, Lakshman acts quickly to save Sita and cuts off Shurpanakha's nose.
Let's go. Don't
Shurpanakha, angry and seeking revenge on Ram and Lakshman, rushes to get help from her brother, King Ravan of Lanka. Ravan, the mighty demon king, is powerful and strong. He is a longtime devotee of Lord Shiva, and with Shiva's blessings, has become invincible. On hearing about his sister's mistreatment, Ravan plots revenge. He plans to kidnap Sita and asks Marich, another demon, to disguise himself in the form of a golden deer to lure Ram and Lakshman away. Marich, disguised as a golden deer, hangs around Ram and Sita's hut. Sita is mesmerized by the golden deer and, unable to lure it, asks Ram to catch it for her. Trying to catch the deer, Ram follows it deep into the woods. Soon after Ram disappears into the forest, Ram's voice is heard calling, "Lakshman, help me!" Hearing Ram's voice crying for help, Sita is terrified and orders Lakshman to go into the forest to help Ram. Hesitant to leave Sita alone, Lakshman draws a magical line in front of the house and tells Sita not to cross the line under any circumstances. He tells her she'll be safe inside this line. Ravan, who is secretly watching, disguises himself as a sage and goes to Sita to beg for alms. Sita tries to give Ravan her offerings from within the line that Lakshman drew, but Ravan, disguised as a sage, threatens to curse Sita's whole family if she refuses to come out of the magical line and give him his alms. Anticipating no danger from a sage and fearing his curse, Sita reluctantly crosses the Lakshman Rekha. The moment she does so, Ravan transforms into his true demon form, kidnaps Sita, and flees in his flying chariot.
Thank you.
Sita cries for help from the flying chariot. Jatayu, the vulture, hears Sita's cries and tries to fight the mighty Ravan. Ravan cruelly cuts off Jatayu's wings and leaves him to die, taking Sita away to Lanka. Ram and Lakshman come back after chasing the golden deer, and seeing Sita missing, they set out to look for her. On their way, they find the wounded Jatayu. Jatayu informs them of the kidnapping and dies. Ram is enraged and vengeful. He vows to kill Ravan and rescue Sita.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Ramayana, the journey of Prince Ram, a dance ballet presented by the Sampradaya dance troupe, directed by Smitha Khullar. During the search for Sita, Ram meets Hanuman, the monkey god and minister in King Sugriv's land. They both pledge their support to Ram, and the Monkey King Sugriv sends his troops in all directions to search for Sita. Ram gives Hanuman his ring as a sign of identification for Sita to know that Ram has sent Hanuman.
Thank you.
Hanuman reaches Lanka, finds Sita, and gives her Ram's ring. However, Hanuman is caught by Ravan's soldiers. To teach Hanuman a lesson, Ravan orders Hanuman's tail to be set on fire. With his flaming tail, Hanuman runs and jumps all around the whole city of Lanka, creating mayhem and burning the place down.
ಕೇಸರಿ ನಂದನ ತೇಜ ಪ್ರತಾಪ ಮಹಾಜಗಬಂಧನ
ಶಂಕರ ಸುವನ ಕೇಸರಿ ನಂದನ ತೇಜ ಪ್ರತಾಪ ಮಹಾಜಗಬಂಧನ
ವಿದ್ಯಾವಾನ ಗುಣಿ ಅತಿ ಚಾತುರ ರಾಮ ಕಾಜ ಕರಿಬೇಕೋ ಆತುರ
ವಿದ್ಯಾವಾನ ಗುಣಿ ಅತಿ ಚಾತುರ ರಾಮ ಕಾಜ ಕರಿಬೇಕೋ ಆತುರ
ಪ್ರಭು ಚರಿತ ಸುನಬೇಕು ರಸಿಯ ಪ್ರಭು ಚರಿತ ಸುನಬೇಕು ರಸಿಯ ರಾಮ ಲಖನ ಸೀತಾವನ ಬಸಿಯ
Thank you. महासुख होई जो ये पढ़े हनुमान चालीसा हो ये सिद्धि साखी गौरी सा सीता से सदा
of Sita, Ram and his army prepare for war. One of Ravan's brothers, Vibhishan, decides to join Ram's army as he strongly believes that Ravan is in the wrong. Ram prays to Lord Shiva for his blessings. Hanuman asks all the monkeys to write the name of Ram on all the rocks and stones and throw them into the water to make a bridge across the ocean to go to the island of Lanka. And so begins the war between Ravan's Rakshas Sena, army of demons, and Ram's Vanar Sena, army of monkeys.
Shambho
The war continues for many days. After suffering some losses, Ravan decides to send his giant powerful brother Kumbhakarna to war. Kumbhakarna crushes most of Ram's army, but is finally stopped by Hanuman and killed by Ram. But at the same time, Indrajit, the powerful son of Ravan, injures Lakshman, who falls unconscious. The only way to save Lakshman is by giving him the Sanjeevani medicinal herb that grows in the Himalaya mountains. Hanuman volunteers to fly and bring the herb back. However, unable to identify the herb, Hanuman lifts an entire mountain and brings it back, allowing Lakshman to be saved. Vibhishan and Lakshman conspire to kill Ravan's powerful son, Indrajit. Indrajit is a very accomplished warrior, undefeated in battle. Vibhishan reveals that he can be killed at his weakest moment when he's praying early in the morning. Lakshman stealthily goes to Indrajit's lair and in the battle that follows, kills him. Ravan, enraged at the death of his son and brother, emerges fiercely to fight with Ram. After an intense battle, Ram finally kills Ravan and rescues Sita. We'll be right back. Ram, Sita and Lakshman returned to Ayodhya after 14 years. Ram is coronated the king and the whole kingdom celebrates the return of Ram and the dawn of a new era by lighting lamps, diyas, fireworks and lots of food, music and dancing.
ಚಂದನಾನು
so the story of Ramayana continues to be told until this day. An inspiring saga of the ultimate victory of good and just over evil and unjust. Thousands of years later, we continue to commemorate this story through the celebration of the Diwali festival. May the light of justice, knowledge, and wisdom always shine bright. Happy Diwali.
Ramayana as much as we enjoyed dancing to it and making it. It's been a long journey and lots of people come. It was just a small dream of mine to do Ramayana sometime, but it snowballed into such a beautiful production with all the parents pitching in and all the talents coming out, whether it was the sets or the costumes. Everything went so beautifully, and their support is what made this possible the way it is today. And Sridhar and Prashant are always there to support till the end. Whatever I have to say in the last second for the light cues or the music, I'm screaming and texting from the back, but then they're always there to support. And I would like to make a few special mentions. One is for narration, Nitin Karandikar. Thank you very, very much. And if you all remember, we used to watch Mahabharata, and whenever that the wheel of time is to come and they used to say, Main Samay Hoon. That's exactly what I told Nitin. I want that voice, Nitin. Main Samay Hoon. I used to get goosebumps and I used to be sitting down to watch Mahabharata for 1 hour. And he did excellent. Thank you, Nitin. And on the sets, I want to make a special mention of Subhash Jain and the beautiful columns and the hut and all the props that you see have been made by him. Thank you, Subhash Jain. Of self-interest because our kids were dancing in the production. But I want to make a special mention of Padma, that she selflessly volunteered all her effort and time in doing the costumes. She has 3 sons. One of her kids were dancing in this production. Just for her friendship and for the belief of this Ramayana, she spent all the effort and time for us. Thank you very much. So thank you all for watching.
Thank you very much for coming. I don't have words to express how amazing the fusion of the old and the new. You know, so many languages and so many children, so many ages. It is so amazing. In fact, I'll be honest, today was the first time I actually watched it in the morning because I had to do a few supporting things. And I did not want to watch it because I wanted to come and watch it towards the end. It is really, really amazing. Please give a big applause to Smitha and her team. And now, on behalf of the Hindu Temple of Eastern Iowa, I would like to request Professor Satish Khera to come into stage and give a small token of the gifts prepared by the parents of this troupe for Smitha.
Good evening. What a mesmerizing and thrilling experience it was for me, and I'm sure it was equally thrilling for you. I had tears in my eyes quite a few times, especially during the monkey and the bad guy's fight sequence. A Bollywood director needs to come and get some training here. How to get 4 and 5 year olds. Where are you, little girls? Beautiful, just loved all of you. Absolutely thrilling. It is a distinct honor for me to present this with gratitude and thank you to all of you, each and every one. I don't know all your names, but I recognize by your talent, each and every one of you. Thank you for your hard work, and thank you, Smitha, for what you did.
So The kids have done an amazing job. They need to get something. At least we need to announce their names so you know it. So on behalf of the Temple of Eastern Iowa, I'm going to present a certificate for each of the kids. Please hold your applause until the end, until we have announced all the names. First one is Lakshmi Shanti Chere. And forgive me if I don't pronounce any of the names correctly. I apologize upfront. Manjushri Sankepalli. Christy Anil. Rajini Gopishetty. Anjali Matthews. Anjali Lodh. Neha Yakala. Tara Rajagopal. Tanvi Pagga. Vishmita Yupala. Deeksha Raghavan. Aksheta Naveen Kumar. Palak Srivastava. Srinidhi Kompela. Sanvi Nallu. Ritvika Shivaprakash. Shrenya Sankepalli. Tanushri Khullar. Shruti Gopishetty. Yukta Borse. Avani Gopalakrishna. Anya Reddy. Tulip Srivastava. Anushka Saxena. Amy Anil. Mohana Sunkara. Trisha Kapoor. Lasya Yakala. Shreya Kullar. Akshya Warrior. Khushi Kapoor. Himani Laroya. Simran Sareen. Niyati Vyas. Aditi Borde. Varsha Borde. And finally, Kritika Iyer. A big round of applause for these children. Thank you very much. Thank you for everyone who supported this. Please drive safe. Thank you.